Before crimping a terminal onto the end of a wire, you first need to strip some insulation off of the end, and that's exactly what we're going to cover here in lesson number 3 of this wire terminals playlist. My name is Nate, and welcome to the EXPLORIST Life Mobile, Marine, and Off-Grid Electrical Academy. Now, stripping wire is super simple given you have the right tools for the job. So in this video, I'm going to share my personal choices for the right tools for the job. Stripping small wire from 22 to 10 gauge. Now, I consider small wire to be anything that's smaller than 10 gauge. And for this, I like to use self-adjusting wire strippers. Now for this, we can simply put the wire into the jaws like so, and then squeeze the handle and the tool does the rest of the job for us. Now these are great because of how fast they can strip different sizes of wire back to back. You know, we can just not change anything, go from 16 gauge wire here, strip off the insulation, and then immediately go over to 10 gauge and then strip the insulation from that as well. Stripping mid-sized wire from 8 gauge to 6 gauge plus solar wire. For wires from 8 gauge to 6 gauge, I reach for my Klein 11053 wire strippers. With these, we can just match up the wire size with the label on the strippers, squeeze the handle, and pull the insulation off. Now, sometimes this wire is SGX insulation, which is actually kind of tough to pull it off of the wire. And for this, if you run into this, you can just use the adjustable wire strippers, put it into place, even though it's technically too big a wire, and then use the adjustable wire strippers to help you pull the insulation off. Now, I also use these Klein 11053 wire strippers for solar wire. Now, solar wire has a really tough, thick insulation on it since it's exposed to the outside elements. And the adjustable wire strippers, well, that worked, but it typically doesn't work. And so I'll use these Klein strippers to kind of score the insulation like so with the 10 gauge setting. And then I'll use the adjustable wire strippers to sort of help out with the process. Now, you might get lucky like I just did, and these work for the solar wires, but now you have some tools in your arsenal to help with the process. Stripping large wire from 4 gauge to 4/0. If you followed EXPLORIST Life for a while, you've seen me recommend this Jokari cable knife for stripping wire larger than 4 gauge. And in all honesty, it's still a good tool, but I sort of never really use it anymore as it simply takes a little too long for my liking and I feel like I'm actually not as accurate with it. Instead, I'm just going to use the Klein 63030 coaxial cutters that I use to cut the wire. I'll just put the wire into the cutters, apply some light pressure, and then spin the cutters around the insulation until it cuts almost all the way through, going by feel. And then work the insulation off left and right until the insulation comes off. Now, the main thing to pay attention here is don't cut too deep. Don't apply too much pressure. Once you feel the wires on the inside, stop and try to pull the insulation off because it's really easy to cut into these really fine stranded wires on the inside. And if you lose a bunch of the strands, you can't use this wire. So maybe practice this technique with a scrap piece of wire before doing it for real on your cut to length wire. Now you'll likely have multi-conductor wire in your electrical system somewhere, whether it's 10-2 Romex or 12-3 stranded wire or 6-3 SO cord. But for all of these, I don't really have any different tools. Now for 10 gauge 3 conductor wire and smaller, to strip some of that off, I'm simply going to use the adjustable wire strippers I showed you earlier. And I'll just put it in place on the outer sheath and then give it a squeeze and it pulls the outer sheath right off like so. And then from there, I'm just left with 10 gauge individual strand wires, which at that point I can just use those adjustable wire strippers to strip off the 10 gauge just in the same manner that I did earlier. Now for a larger wire, if it's round like 6/3 SO cord, I'm just going to use the Klein coaxial cutters wherever those went over, and apply some light pressure on the outer sheath going around, just the same as I did with the 4-aught wire from earlier, being very careful because it's super easy to cut through the insulation on the inner wires. And I'm just going to work that back and forth, being very careful, and eventually I'll be able to get to the inside wires where I can pull the insulation off. And then from there, I'm just left with 3 6-gauge wires, which I can then strip in the exact same manner that I showed earlier, just like so. Now, if it's large flat wire like this 6-gauge 3-conductor flat wire, you know, there's really not a tool that does a great job with that. And so I'm just going to resort to a utility knife and then cut the wire in between the strands of wire, being really careful not to cut the inner strands of wire or their insulation, like so. And then I can just peel that insulation off of the end, peel it back like this, and then use my knife or some scissors to cut this off. Like so. Not super elegant, but that's how I do it. How far back to strip wire? Now there's no one right answer for how far back to strip the insulation from wire, because it really just depends on what component you're connecting it to, but here are some helpful tips. Sometimes the user manual of the device or component will tell you how far back to strip the insulation. Sometimes the actual component will tell you how far back to strip the insulation. And if neither of those are options, just use the physical barrel length of whatever terminal that you're using and a pin to mark where that insulation should be stripped off to. And if it's a screw terminal and you're not using a ferrule, I'll just stick a screwdriver into the powered off component and then measure with my finger. And then that's how far back you're going to have to strip the wire, and just transcribe that mark to the wire. Now, to summarize all of this, here is a graph of what wire strippers I use for various sizes of wire. Now, with just 3 basic hand tools, one of which you're already going to have from our wire cutting 101 video, you're going to be able to strip the insulation from any wire you'll encounter for your next mobile, marine, or off-grid electrical project. Now, we're going to be stripping wires throughout the rest of this academy, so be sure to bookmark this lesson for future reference and come back to it if you need a refresher, because going forward, I'm just going to assume that you now know how to strip wires. Now that you know how to strip wires, I'm going to teach you everything you need to know about heat shrink. So click up here to watch, and I'll see you over there.